Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to a brand new video, one that I am so excited to be bringing you. It is one of many gift guides to come over this next week, 2-3 weeks even, maybe even do some last minute gift guides. I just have so many gift ideas that I want to give to you guys that I realize I'm going to have to break these down into individual videos just because there's so many things and my creative brain is going. So the first one, which I'm going to start with today, is like a general gift guide for her video. So I feel like if there's anything in this video that you see that you like, maybe you could send it to your boyfriends or your mums and dads if they need gift ideas. And then one that you can definitely refer to if you're buying for your mother, your sister, any of the women in your life, this is for you. So sit back, relax, grab yourselves a nice cozy hot drink and maybe get pen and paper ready if you want to jot down some ideas. If you do want to stay tuned for my upcoming gift guides, my stocking fillers, gift guides for him, for her, luxury, beauty, any suggestions as well, put them in the comments below. But if you do want to stay tuned for my future gift guides coming very soon, then be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell. I will also leave a link to my Instagram accounts down below. I have two, fashion and homeware, because I love both. And I will try and leave links to everything that I include within this video down in the description box as well for you to simply click through and shop. So without further ado, let's get started with the first gift guide of 2K19. So of course, the first gift that I had to include was my Foreo Luna 3. I'm sure many of you guys who are not new to my channel will have seen this in vlogs and recent videos. I have been using the Foreo Luna 3 for a while now and I am absolutely loving it. If you did want to check it out yourself, again, link will be left in the description box below. But they actually have a whole range of different devices. Mine is the Luna 3, but you can have a look, browse their website and see if there are other devices that might suit you better, might suit your budget better. But this one for me has been a godsend. I love the fact that it connects with my app. I can use the front to cleanse my face and then the ridges along the back to give myself a little massage. They have different massage functions on the app which you can select, and a program which you follow which helps contour and tighten, and oh my god, it's amazing. So I really, really love this. I use this to cleanse my face every single day. And then I also recently discovered the Foreo UFO mask, which it's like a smart device that uses light technology and heat technology as well. You can buy different types of actual masks that you use, so you can interchange as well using the same device but different masks. And you simply follow the instructions, pop it on, and then again using the app on your phone, you just follow the instructions of where to go on your face, and it tells you, it talks you through the benefits of the technology used and what it does to your skin. So this is like a little luxury. I would say the Luna 3 for me now is a necessity, whereas this is a nice little luxury. So maybe if you're buying for someone who already has a Foreo device, like a cleansing device, maybe you could treat them to the UFO smart mask, because honestly, it is like going to the spa. It's amazing. A little luxury item here, a little designer coin purse. If you're buying for someone who likes a bit of designer, then I find that coin purses are a really reasonable, I mean, it depends on your budget. As with everything within this video, you'll see that I have different products for different budgets. But this is like a little luxury you want to buy for someone who you don't really know what to get them, but they like designer. A coin purse is amazing. I actually got this for my 21st birthday. I'm now 27 and I use this on a daily basis. I love the fact that it's pretty much cards, a couple of notes and a couple of coins, and it's very minimal, slips into any size handbag. And this is one from Louis Vuitton. If it's available still, I'll leave it linked. I think these are around the £100 to £150 mark. I love my little Louis Vuitton coin purse, and I think this would be a nice treat for someone to open if you're looking to spend the hundreds not thousands, on a designer item, a little coin purse is a great starting point. Okay, the next thing that I wanted to include within this video is some kind of 2020 calendar. This one I actually picked up from HomeSense. I feel like HomeSense really have a great range of calendars and diaries and journals. So that is the place that I would recommend. Failing that, maybe Paper Chase could be a good option. Oliver Bonus as well. So a nice little calendar is a must for someone like me. If you are a stationery lover, you like writing notes and jotting things down, 2020 calendar is my next item. Followed similarly and closely is this happiness planner. As opposed to a diary and a dated diary, I feel like a happiness planner is a great option to buy for someone who likes to manifest, likes to, I don't know, reflect quite a lot and write goals and targets. And the happiness planner has so many different kind of guided day-to-day pages, which allows you to get your mind thinking and jotting down. And just for instance, this one that I've opened up on is rate how you feel on a score of 1 to 5. That is just an example of what one of the pages looks like. So yeah, the happiness planner is a great gift and is my next suggestion. This is a new addition, which was a treat from myself to myself, and it is Mrs. Hinch's activity journal. This is her second book. She has the first one, which is like a guided book of how she cleans and tips and tricks and all that kind of thing. But this is more up my street with activities. So there's Find the Minky, there's crosswords, there's word searches with words relating to what Mrs. Hinch uses, colouring, reasons to be grateful checklist. There's all sorts in here. So I've really been enjoying going through this on like Sunday evenings, reflection over the week, and kind of lists of what to do for the following week. So I love this. I actually got it on Amazon when it was on half price, so stay tuned for any offers, but I will leave a link to this below. I love it. Sticking with books, but going a little more high end, I have these designer books. I have a Tom Ford one and a Chanel one. They're so heavy. They make perfect coffee table books. So if the person that you're buying for maybe has recently moved out or has, you know, likes interiors, these make great coffee table books that are like statement, they're heavy. They're actually good reads as well. There's lots of nice imagery in these, and for me they kind of just sit and look pretty. And you can buy these in places like Selfridges full price, but in HomeSense and TK Maxx, which is where I actually got both of these, they are more reasonably priced, between the sort of £20 to £40 mark, as opposed to quite a bit, like double that. So definitely keep your eyes peeled in HomeSense and TK Maxx. Our local TK Maxx actually has all of them at the minute, the Louis Vuitton, the Dior. I am tempted to get a couple more, but I do quite like just the black and white ones. So I'm gonna put this down now because it's very heavy. Of course, within the gift guide for her, I'm gonna include a fragrance. My favorite fragrance is the Jo Malone Myrrh and Tonka. In particular for wintry kind of months, this is very rich, deep, warm. I absolutely love this. It's my all-time favourite fragrance, so I had to include it. But quite frankly, any Jo Malone fragrance, Papa Luxury, is a must. I like all of their fragrances, I really do. They're unisex as well, their fragrances as well, so it could kind of balance into the gift guide for him as well. But yeah, Myrrh and Tonka, I had to include that. Also Jo Malone candles, obviously, but for a slightly more affordable but still luxury company. Neom, I love their scents. Oh my god, it smells incredible. I'm yet to burn it. It smells a good one for the bathroom, this one. It is the Scent to Boost Your Energy Feel Refreshed scented candle. But I love Neom candles. I, on the odd occasion, spot them in TK Maxx and HomeSense. White Company is another brand that you guys know I'm obsessed with. White Company. Big, big fan of the White Company, and all of their scents, again, are amazing. So if, like me, you're buying for someone who likes home fragrance, then that would be a good shout. And that kind of leads on nicely to a brand that I am obsessed with. Rituals is another brand that I absolutely love for home fragrance, but also skincare, fragrance, body care, and all that kind of stuff as well. They are amazing. I believe Little Birdie once told me they're made in the same factory as Tom Ford, pretty much the same products, but these are more reasonably priced. Tom Ford is definitely high end, whereas these I'd say are mid-range. So this candle, let me see if I can open it, is Holy Smoke, it's called. And oh my God, it smells like the White Company Fireside, but even stronger. And look how luxurious their packaging as well is. I have a bigger reed diffuser from them as well in black oud, which is that kind of color. But they also have more reasonably sized and reasonably priced reed diffusers in these like cylinder shapes. This one is The Ritual of Happy Buddha, smile and the world smiles back. Oh, I love that quote. I always say that that's a favorite quote of mine. This is in sweet orange and cedarwood, so quite a nice seasonally appropriate scent. I can smell it without even opening it. That's how strong they are. Okay, next product that I wanted to share with you is Slip products. This one is a pure silk sleep mask, and it was actually part of a PR package from ShopStyle. So I actually have engraved on this one ShopStyle, but I use this on the odd occasion if Tom is maybe watching something in bed on his iPad and it's too bright and then I'm tired and want to go to sleep. I'll put this on, or for flights, they're also really good. The idea is with the Slip silk sleep masks is that they, because they are silk, they are less harsh on your skin. They also do pillowcases as well. So again, it's meant to help with less likely to get wrinkles because of the harshness sometimes of cotton or other fabrics versus silks. So yeah, it's like a little luxury, but a little affordable luxury. I feel like another essential within a gift guide for her is of course beauty and makeup, and I've pulled together out of my collection of makeup palettes three of my favourites, which I think are good staples that any girl could get on with, and two of which are Anastasia Beverly Hills. Both of these I love, but all of their palettes are like known and loved because of the pigment and the quality. They are incredible. So this one is the Subculture palette, and they are the colors within this palette. Nice warm browns and kind of greens, perfect for autumn and winter. And then this one, Soft Glam, is even more so wearable, I would say, with it being predominantly warm browns and champagnes and pinky kind of tones. Similarly to the Soft Glam, the warm browns, the everyday kind of neutrals, all the Urban Decay Naked palettes are amazing, but this one, Naked Heat, is my favorite, so much so that I actually have the Heat Petite as well, which would be a good little stocking filler. And these are the colors within this palette. I'm trying to show you without showing you the mirror. So again, nice warm browns, neutrals that just are so wearable that any of those palettes I would recommend. Okay, these next two are for a little, I don't know, the country bumpkins out there that like long countryside winter walks like I'm obsessed with. That's why I need a dog. I just feel like it would complete my long wintry walks. So one of which is a scarf, and I actually got gifted this one, which is probably my favorite scarf I own. It's in this gorgeous camel color, and it is of course embossed, as you can tell. Now I'm not sure exactly where my brother and his girlfriend got this from for me for last year, but I have looked online and seen some on Not on the High Street and on Etsy, so I'll leave a couple down below. But I love the neutral tone for this, very me. I love the monogram. Just a little personal touch like this just goes a long way. I think any kind of gift with personalization is all the more thoughtful, so I love that. I got gifted these recently from Fairfax and Favour, made in England. Oh my God, these are amazing. These are a pair of boots in the color chocolate. They are suede Chelsea boots. These are definitely like a luxury item to gift someone. Make sure you find out their size though, and if you do know their size, size up in these. I'm usually a 6.5, and well, 6 to 6.5, and these I got in a 7. But as you can tell, they're a gorgeous, rich, chocolatey brown, just a little less harsh than black. But I love these. They smell amazing, and I love the fact that each boot comes in its own little Fairfax and Favour duster bag. Okay, so three things that kind of tie in with each other, which I don't actually have to show you, which is a little bit annoying, but I'll just run through them quickly. A nice set of pajamas, always a great gift. Maybe a good like Christmas Eve gift idea as well. A dressing gown and slippers. I particularly love my UGG slippers. They're here somewhere, but they're like a year old, so they're a little bit tatty now, so I didn't want to show you them. But UGG slippers are incredible. I'll leave a link to the ones that I have below. I'm obsessed with them, absolutely love them. And a good staple dressing gown. In particular, my favorite dressing gowns are the White Company ones. Nice fluffy white robe. Maybe not for someone who fake tans quite a lot. Look at the lighting. It's because it's sunny outside. Can you see the sun here? That's a little bit annoying, sorry about that. Something again fun and kind of sticking in line with the personalization type gifts is this. This is a ring making kit from Cursed Jewelry. This is actually from last year, but I know that they are selling more again this year. And essentially you get a whole kit to design and create your own ring, which you send off and they send it back to you in either gold or silver, your chosen metal. And I think that is fun for if you're buying for someone who's quite creative. I actually designed and made my own one with them last year, which is this one. It's a nice chunky gold that I made, so I'm tempted to maybe make another one for myself using that kit and using the thinner mold to maybe get like a slightly less chunky version of a very same one and then layer them, because I love this. And also you can stick with personalized gifts in terms of hampers. You can be so creative and create a personalized hamper for someone that you love. They have these hamper sets available in B&M, probably are the best place to get them from. Home Bargains I know do them as well, but they are around about, I want to say, £5 for a big hamper. All the stuffing, the everything that you need, the bow and everything comes with it. And you can fill it with pamper goodies. If the person you're buying for loves beauty, you could fill it with chocolates and foods and treats and alcohol. If they are into food and drinks, you can fill it with cleaning products. I actually built a Mrs. Hinch hamper. Or a Hinch hamper for one of my friends who also loves Mrs. Hinch. So for her birthday, I created her like a hamper filled with like Mrs. Hinch favorites, and I put her book in there as well for her. So that's quite a, you know, quite an affordable gift to create, but it's personalized as well, which I love. Or maybe the person's into home fragrance, you could put in some like Sephloras, some candles, some reed diffusers, and create like a little home fragrance hamper. That is one that I would love to receive. Just putting that out there into the universe for anyone that potentially could be watching. Okay, this one is probably the least seasonally appropriate gift idea, but one that I received 1 year and was so grateful for. So it is sunglasses. I have a selection here, of which I was going to just show you my three favorites, but I just think this is a great idea because they're going to last forever. And if you have any winter holidays booked, like I'm going to South Africa at the end of December for 2 weeks, which is just so exciting. So I have this one, which is kind of reasonably priced, Key Australia. They do some really nice different styles and so accessible online. You can just buy them. Loads of places sell them. These are the ones that I actually got as a Christmas gift 1 year, and that are a classic that I honestly will have forever, unless if I ruin them or break them. But even then, I'd probably repurchase the exact same style. It is the aviator in gold with a green lens. I love them. They are just like my everyday go-to sunglasses. And then if you like a little more designer and a little more fashion, then these ones from Gucci are really nice as well. I love the brown tortoiseshell, and they have the little bee on the edge there. So these are quite big, more statement. Okay, so one kind of brand that I opt for, especially for my parents every year, is Molton Brown. They have some new scents out, which are very festive and look gorgeous. How pretty are these? Can you see all the sparkles and the shimmers in there? So this one really intrigued me. It's in Bazaar Brandy. They have a whole range of products within that new Christmassy scent, as they do with this one as well, which is vintage with elderflower. These are the bath and shower gels. They also do loads of different Christmassy gift sets. This one is in suede orris, I believe. Yeah, so it comes with the bath and shower gel in that same size, and you also get a fragrance as well, which I think is a really nice gift, because for a lot of perfume brands that do a perfume and then they include either like a body moisturizer or a shower gel in there, to be honest with you, the shower gel is fairly average, let's be honest. But Molton Brown are known for their shower gels, so the fact that you're kind of getting the shower gel as the gift with a fragrance with it, and their fragrances are amazing. So I really love, if you're going to get a duo and a, you know, like a perfume with a gift set, then I would always opt for Molton Brown. I did also want to mention like experiences, because for the person that has everything, I do think a experience is quite a good idea, whether it be show tickets or spa days. Something that you can experience with loved ones is the best gift idea, isn't it? Let's be honest. And it's personalized. You're gonna create memories from it. And yeah, I mean, I don't have anything to show you, but I just think that's a great idea. But the last thing that I did want to mention as well in terms of gift guides ideas is an early Christmas gift, because it is an advent calendar. I have this one to show you, the Look Fantastic one, because I believe these, I mean, at the time of filming this video, I did check and they are still in stock, but advent calendars go pretty quickly. So I'll leave a link to it below. Try and get your hands on it if you can. Look Fantastic is, in my opinion, one of the best advent calendars out there for mid-range price point and best value for money. Yeah, value for money, because you get quite a lot of gifts like and good decent product sizes in there as well. But if you want to spend a little less and get one that is still high end, then Beauty Expert do one for, I think this is £100, but it is only 12 days. So I think it's still the element of luxury, but more reasonable in terms of price point, because you do only essentially have the 12 days. I will be opening my advent calendars. I have a couple more as well downstairs, but these two I knew, especially like I said at the time of filming this, were still in stock, so I'll leave them linked if they still are available. But I do have a few more to open, and I will be doing so throughout December. I'm doing Vlogmas this year, but I'm not going to do it how I did last year. I'm going to do it as my weekly vlogs. I just feel like quality over quantity, because I don't want to feel rushed and just get loads of like average vlogs out there and feel stressed with it and having to schedule, and I struggled with it last year. I really did. Not to say I'll never do it again in the future, but this year I want to trial just doing my weekly vlogs, but obviously Vlogmas 1, 2, 3, 4, and still vlog every day, so you're still seeing me opening my advent calendars every day. I hope you don't mind, because I also have loads of ideas of video content that I want to put out there, like sit down hauls and decorating my house, home tours, Christmassy videos that aren't necessarily vlog styles. So that's the plan. Let me know your feedback. Let me know any kind of festive videos that you want throughout November and December, and I can be sure to add it to my checklist and diary of scheduled videos. I hope you enjoyed this first of many gift guides to come, and any suggestions of places you want to shop, maybe I can do brand specific ones like budget B&M ones. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thumbs up if you did. Again, don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell to be notified when I upload my next videos. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you all in my next video. Bye guys.